Hey guys, Tim from Snowskiers Warehouse here. Welcome back to our video series where we answer some of the most commonly asked questions when people come in store. Today, we try and answer the age-old question, gloves versus mitts. I like gloves.
Mitts.
Gloves, so you can give snowboarders the finger.
As you can see, even in our own shop, we can't come up with a definitive answer which one is better. Some of us wear gloves, the other half of them, they wear mitts. There's no right or wrong answer to the question. They're just different in their own right. And the differences between those two are very straightforward and simple to understand. Everybody knows that, you know, gloves, fingers are separated. In your mitts, your fingers are all in the main compartment, and that does create more warmth. There's no doubt about that. But do you lose a lot of the function of being able to adjust your goggles or pull a zipper up, holding ski stocks or even doing your binding buckles? No, I think you can still do most of those things as you would with gloves. However, if you do need to use tools, a screwdriver or anything like that, yes, undoubtedly having the dexterity of a pair of gloves does allow you to maintain the ability to do those sort of things. But between the two for the main usage, gloves versus mitts, it's still a personal opinion. However, when people ask us, what's better for kids? Well, the question is still dexterity versus warmth. But in kids, it's the only time I would say that there is an advantage of mitts versus gloves. With the kids' mitts, they just open up, put their hand in, zip it up or cinch it down. It's a much easier procedure than trying to get sweaty, sticky little fingers into the correct spot. Instead of one finger here, one there, a thumb tucked in there, it's just a harrowing experience for everyone. Do yourself a favor, if you got youngsters, just get the mitts. You'll notice we do have gloves for kids, but they can only be suited to, say, ages 10 and up. And at that point, you would assume that the kids are a little more familiar with how a glove's supposed to fit, and they should be a little more self-sufficient and not be bothering you to put them on for you all the time. So that's the only time I think that there is an advantage between mitts and gloves. So that's that, the age-old question, gloves versus mitts. Were we able to answer that for you definitively? Probably not. I don't think it's a question that really needs to be answered anyway. They both have their pros and cons, and you guys can choose that for yourself. Dexterity versus warmth is probably the biggest factor between the two. But when it comes to warmth, just like outerwear, there are a number of options when it comes to choosing how thick or how warm or how waterproof you want it. And all those numbers that we've covered in an earlier episode transfer through to gloves. And all of that sort of stuff is normally available on the packaging, so you can compare it from one product to the next. But in the end, if you can't decide which party you want to attend, you can just go out and sit on the fence and get yourself a pair of these bad boys. That's right, trigger mitts. These two go to work, these three stay in bed. Kind of weird, but it works. And if you like any of the gear I've been wearing in this particular video, be sure to check out our online store at www.snowskierswarehouse.com.au for all the flyest gear. I am feeling this jumbo cord getup in particular. And thanks for watching another episode of the Da Vinci Code of Snow Gear. If you think there's anything that we've missed, or if you have any questions about anything you want to know about in the next episode, feel free to drop a comment below. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram to stay up to date on everything that's happening in store and for the upcoming ski season. In the meantime, stay frosty.